Hello, welcome back to my channel, and welcome to this new filming location. I'm here at my desk because I'm going to be telling you all about how I plan my content. Now, I know this is a video that's probably only going to interest about two of you, but I have gotten a few different questions over the years about how I plan my content, how I decide what books I'm going to read for various videos, and I decided to answer all of those questions here in this video. So it's going to be kind of a mixed format thing. I'm going to walk you through the steps of how I get a video from just an idea in my head to a video that actually goes live, and then I'm gonna jump into a Q&A section, which should hopefully answer any remaining questions that you might have. So the first thing that I like to do is throw ideas into the notes app on my phone. Now, I've experimented with different formats on how I like to kind of brainstorm and collect video ideas, but by far the easiest and most convenient way to do that is the notes app. The reason I use it is because my phone is always with me and I always like to create a running list in there, and I can check things off as I go in a way that is easily switchable. I think you're gonna notice in my content planning that a lot of what I do is digital pre-planning, and then for the actual nitty-gritty day-to-day, I use paper planning. So the first thing I do is open up my notes app, and then I start brainstorming ideas. Now, I will say the brainstorming process for me is not something that I do on a regular basis. I don't really sit down and think, okay, let's think of video ideas. It's like a video idea will come to me and then I will throw it into my notes app. Usually I just write down the rough video title in my notes app so I can kind of remember what I was thinking at the time, but on occasion I will end up writing books down as well. I think that's a question that's going to be asked later. What comes first, the video idea or the books that you want to read for that video? And it kind of just depends on what I'm thinking. Sometimes I'll think of a video idea and I'm like, you know, I really want to read these Dark Academia books, therefore I'm going to make a Dark Academia video. Sometimes I will think, I really want to make a Dark Academia video. Let me find some books for it. You know, it just kind of depends on what's going on. But as you can see in this example right here, my notes app is kind of a mess, especially this particular note. Sometimes it'll just be, again, rough video titles, and then other times it'll be video title plus books that I intend to read for that video. So it's kind of a mishmash of different things, but I try to keep it really loose and free-flowing. I sometimes will cross through things that I've already done or delete things. And that's kind of why, again, I love digital note-taking and pre-planning, because it's just so easy to kind of switch things up whenever I want to. So that's the first step, is putting things into my notes app, which moves us into step two, which is pre-planning. Now, this is certainly not something that everyone is going to need to do, depending on kind of how you get your books for videos. I think that this is a step that you could completely eliminate. For me, this is something that is absolutely necessary, and I think gives me some of the freedom that I really crave when I'm trying to plan videos far in advance. I haven't said it yet, but I am not a type A personality, and while I really like problem solving and like puzzling things together, I'm not someone who is super, super organized, and this is a way that helps me stay organized. And the main tool that I use in this kind of step two pre-planning phase is iCalendar. So I will show you an example of an iCalendar month for me. This is where I do the bulk of my pre-planning. Whenever I'm in my notes app and I have found videos that I'm so excited about and really want to kind of put down for the month, I will grab things from my notes app and throw them into my iCalendar. I usually like to plan no farther than a month in advance, primarily because I get bored pretty easily, and I'm assuming a lot of y'all probably do too. If you also create content, you'll have a really good video idea, you'll put it down, and then you're like, ugh, I don't really want to do this anymore. So planning a month in advance gives me enough time to get excited about stuff, but not so much time to where I'm like, okay, actually I don't want to do this. That makes sense. A month in advance is really my sweet spot. So I just kind of lay out the videos in whatever format I think is necessary, or whatever days I want to put videos on. For me, my content schedule is every Sunday, and then occasionally I will post Tuesday videos, which you can see again on the iCalendar right here. And this isn't super relevant to this particular phase, but you'll notice that there are three different colors in the calendar, and that is just a reminder to me as to what phase the video is in. I'll put the key right here. Yellow is a video that is done. It's completely finished. I've edited, I've uploaded it. It doesn't have to be live yet, but it is a video that's completely finished. An orange video is one that has an intro filmed usually, or like one singular vlog clip filmed, but it's not completely done. And then a red video is one that I've literally just put into my calendar and have not started working on yet, or really even planned books for. So this is just kind of how I start puzzling through what I want to post. And again, I'll be pulling things from my notes app and pulling them into this calendar. And sometimes things will just come to me as the month goes on, or at the beginning of the month, like, ooh, I don't have this written down in my notes ideas, but I do really want to post this video, and I will kind of fit that into the schedule. There isn't a lot of rhyme or reason on how I decide what videos are going to go on which days. The only thing that I try to do is sort of vary the content. So I'm not going to post two I Read 5 videos back to back, or two Kindle Unlimited reading vlogs back to back, or at least I try not to. Sometimes scheduling things make that unavoidable, but 90% of the time I try really hard not to do that. But other than that, I try not to let anything else limit me. I just kind of post what I want, when I want, in advance for a given month. Which leads us into step three, which is the true planning process. I know it seems like we've already done quite a bit of planning, and that's true, but this is where things start to come to life and where the actual video planning really gets into the nitty gritty. So first, working off of my iCalendar, I go into this note and I write down every video that I have pre-planned in order of how I'm planning to post it. So first we've got the wrap up, then we've got the next video and the next video and the next video, all for the month of September. So looking at this note, we know that our first video is going to be a wrap up. A wrap up is not going to require us to read any books, so we don't have to put anything under this particular list item. Now the next video is an I Read 5 video, and we know for an I Read 5 video, we're going to be reading 5 books, so we need to figure out what books we're going to put down. Now for this particular video, the idea came to me because I had two arcs given to me that were hyped romances that were coming out. So I knew that 2 of the 5 books were going to be arcs. So the first thing I did was put in those 2 arcs and put in parentheses next to it, arc. I like to kind of note where a book is coming from. I think it just helps me whenever I am trying to figure out, oh god, where is this book? How am I reading this book? I don't always do this, but this does help me a lot. So I put in parentheses what the format is or where I'm getting the book from. And then for the other 3 books, I kind of figure out where I want to get these books from. Do I have books with me? Am I going to need to check things out for my library? I think in this particular instance, I had 2 physical copies of hyped romances coming out. When I purchased myself, one that was gifted to me by the publisher, I believe. And then lastly, I was like, okay, there's one book that I really want to check out for my library, so I decided to request it, put it on hold, and then I knew that I was going to have to wait on that particular book for the video to be posted. Thankfully, in this circumstance, I think I only had to wait a couple of weeks, and since I plan a month in advance, it wasn't a big deal. I was able to get the book in time for the video. So I have all 5 of those books written down, I have where they're coming from, and now I know that I can successfully read these books and get them read for the video. And that is the first step in my process. I go through the entire list, I figure out where I'm getting books, and in this process, sometimes things get a little messy, and sometimes I have to kind of move things around. For instance, if I have decided on a particular video, I know what books I want to read, and all of these books are going to be on hold from my library for like 15 plus weeks, this video is probably not going to be able to be posted in this month, and that's where I can go into my iCalendar and literally drag the video to a different day. That's why I just love having a digital planning process in the beginning, because it helps me move things around in a way that's very flexible. I feel like with paper, I love it. I think it's really helpful on a day-to-day basis, but I hate writing down a video, you know, posting date and then having to scratch it out when things don't work out. So digital is the way to go at the very beginning. Now, obviously these calculations are not something that you're going to have to do if you don't use your library. If you're only working with the books that you already have, this is going to be so much easier, and this is a step you could probably completely cut out. It's something that I like. I think it's kind of fun to puzzle out when things are going to be able to be posted based on when I can get things from my library. Sometimes it presents a challenge, but I really enjoy it. And that is kind of the first part of my true planning process. And then we're going to move into step 4, which is how we are actually going to get these books read and how we're going to get the videos done. So step 4 is execution. And this is where paper really comes into play. We've been working with hypotheticals for a while now, trying to figure out, are we able to post these videos at certain times? Are we able to get the books in time for the videos? Now that we know when things are going to come in from the library, we can finally put things down on paper and decide, when am I going to get this stuff read? When am I going to start vlogging for this video? So the key for me for videos and for life is to write down what I'm trying to get accomplished in a given week on paper. I personally use a Hobonichi Kaizen, and I will go ahead and pull up the Kaizen right here so you can kind of see what I'm talking about. So the first thing that I do for a given week is write down when I am posting particular videos, and then I like to consider the length of books for those particular videos. So right here you can see we have the August wrap up. No books are going to be read for this particular video, but for this I Read 5 Hyped Romances video, I know I'm going to have to read 5 books over the course of this week if I have not read any in advance, and I'm going to need to incorporate them into my plans for the week. Now for me, if I have a book that's about 350 pages, I know I can read a book in a day. That's kind of par for the course for romance. If it's a fantasy book, I'm going to need more than a day. I like to write down exactly what I need to get accomplished. Depending on book length and how much time I have to get the video done, I like to write down exactly what I need to do. So in here I have things like finish and vlog the love hypothesis. I'm assuming that when I wrote this down, I was probably like 50% in and I needed to get this done. So I wrote down finish and vlog it. Sometimes I will write something down like 50% clip for this book. So I need to read up to the 50% mark and then film. And that is the process of how I get things done so I can post that Sunday video. Now I'll be honest, this is a very simplified view of things. Usually if a video is getting posted on a Sunday, I've been reading things for this video for more than the week leading up to it. And I'm pretty sure that that was the case for this I Read 5 video right here. So right now, for instance, I have a video that I'm trying to post on a Sunday and I've already read 2 out of 5 books for that. I need to read 3 books this week, but there's also show a book due back at my library in a couple of days for a video that I'm actually posting in December, but I'm going to work that into my reading schedule because I don't want the book to get returned to the library before I can read it. So obviously there's a lot to consider whenever I am kind of planning. When it comes to my reading plans, I don't usually say, finish the Love Hypothesis. I don't write this down on Monday. I usually work day to day and just say, you know what? It's Monday. I really want to finish The Heart Principle and I really want to finish this book. Like that's what I want to get done. Sometimes I'll plan a couple of days in advance, but usually, you know, I just take it day by day and hopefully, you know, make sure that I can get this video posted by the end of the week. And that's kind of how I do things. And that's really what works best for me. It's just planning week to week, day to day on what books I'm going to read for any given video. I think, you know, referring back to my iCalendar to see kind of in advance what's going to be happening over the given month and what's going to happen in the given week in my paper planner, that really, really helps me. I used to do this thing where I would decide when a book needed to be finished in my iCalendar, but I realized I wasn't actually executing on actually reading things in that case. In here, I can actually say, you need to read this today. You need to be able to highlight this and mark it off. And so for me, again, paper really, really works for this particular part of my process. And that's pretty much the process, honestly, from start to finish. Now, obviously there are a couple of things that I'm leaving out, but I'm saving some of those for the Q&A. You're probably wondering, when do you have time to edit? When do you upload these videos? And some of that's written into my planner, but some of that, again, I will answer in the Q&A section. So why don't we go ahead and get into it? I have broken up things into multiple different sections, so you can come back if you have a specific question that you are wanting to get answered or that you maybe forgot the answer to. So the first section is planning and brainstorming. First question is kind of a combination of things. I got this question multiple times in multiple different ways. So do you ever scrap content ideas? Have you decided against a video because it was on trend or wasn't original enough? So yes and no. I have scrapped video ideas before, but it's never because a video isn't original enough or because it's too on trend. If a video is on trend, I feel like I am more likely to post it, though trendiness isn't really something that I take into consideration when I post videos. I think I can name two videos that I've ever created that have been specifically trying to be on trend. Most of the time, I just kind of do what sounds interesting to me. And then when it comes to originality, I wouldn't say that's something that plays a really big part into my decision-making process. I want the video to be interesting. I don't care how original it is. I really want people to enjoy what they're watching. I don't want it to be super boring, but I also don't care if this is the most original idea I've ever posted. I think that was something that plagued me a little bit a couple of years ago. I was like, I have to make every video as original as possible. And now I kind of like a mix of things. Like I like that comforting, just like vlog content. And sometimes I like to do completely off the wall stuff. But when I scrap a video, it's usually not because it's not original or it's too trendy. It's usually because it's not interesting or it's something that I've personally lost interest in and don't want to post anymore. A lot of the times, honestly, that's like fantasy content. I'll be like, oh, it'd be so cool to read this entire series. And then I'm like, I don't think I want to do that. And I also don't really think y'all would like it either. So that is that. Next question, how do you plan massive videos like the 52 book one? Honestly, these are even easier to plan than the videos that I do kind of on a weekly basis. Whenever I come up with a list, I will type it up into my notes app. So I would title it, you know, 52 book video, and then I would write down all of the different books with like a little checklist circle next to it. And I would just read those books whenever I had time. Now for the 52 book video, for instance, I'd read 25 of those books. So I went in and checked all of them off. And then for the other ones, whenever I had available holds at my library, I would try to just go through the list, try to put them on hold whenever they came in. I would read them whenever I had the time between, you know, other planned content. I didn't set a deadline for myself for that video or for most of my list videos. I kind of just try to take things day by day and just have fun. And I think that's why I like my list videos so much. It's just easy to sneak books in whenever I have the chance and the opportunity. So that's how I plan them. I don't really plan them. I just kind of grab the books from my library when I can. And then once it's done, I sit down, script it, film it, edit, upload it. The next question is, do you try and alternate the length of your content, like having shorter videos and then longer videos? I think this is something that I tried to do a couple of years ago. I would try to do like a sit down video and then a vlog. Sit downs tend to be shorter for me than vlogs. At this point, I don't care so much. I do try to kind of limit the length of things. I try to keep things under an hour just to keep people's interest and attention, but I don't really consider the length of videos anymore, mostly because I am posting a lot of the same formats of content. I post fewer recommendation and sit down videos now and a lot more vlog content, which I personally like. I like that progression for me, but no, that's not something I really take into consideration anymore. The next question is, how do you juggle multiple videos at once? I like this question, and I don't know in what way you're asking it, but I'll just answer it in the way that comes to my mind. It's exciting. I love juggling multiple videos at once. And if anything, I think it's what helps me stay focused and helps me stay posting things, right? So I don't want to read 5 books for one video back to back. It doesn't excite me, especially if it's themed. Like if I'm doing a Dark Academia video, I don't want to read 5 Dark Academia books back to back. I would rather read a romance and then a Dark Academia book and then this and that. So if I plan a month in advance, I know what I need to get read and I can read them pretty much in any order. Obviously, like things get posted sequentially, but I have have a little bit of room to kind of play around, and I just think it's fun. I think it's fun doing multiple things at once. It challenges me, it gets me thinking creatively, and the entire process of this is what I like. It's not like I love filming or just love one part of this. I love every aspect of having a YouTube channel and having this be my process. So that's how I juggle multiple things at once. I really like it and it helps me stay focused on reading. Next question is, how do you come up with new creative ideas when it is video related? Now for me personally, and everybody's gonna have their own process, I like to kind of look at the things around me. So I like going to bookstores and looking at books and getting inspired that way, or by getting on the internet. Like I'm on the internet pretty much all day. I think y'all probably are too. And I think that is such a big resource for me. Being on Goodreads, seeing a Goodreads list, thinking, oh, what if I read from a Goodreads list? Looking at my Kindle, reading Kindle books, oh my god, Kindle lock screen ads, oh my god, what if I made a video with Kindle lock screen ads? I wouldn't say my ideas are like the most creative ever, but I just try to keep a really open mind and try to think as creatively as possible as often as possible. You just have to put yourself in that mindset day to day for things to start coming to you. You know what I mean? Like be open to the ideas to come to you. Also, I don't know if I said it, but I've been looking at my phone for these, so I'm sorry if I've been looking down. Last question in the planning section is, do you pick books or theme first? And this is one that I've already sort of talked about, but I did want to kind of expand upon it, which is why I left the question in here. I don't necessarily pick one or the other first. Honestly, random things can kind of dictate what sorts of videos inspire me or like what inspires me to make a video. There have been a couple of times, honestly, when I've thought of thumbnail ideas and that has spurred a video. So it's not really a this or that scenario. It's like anything can inspire a video and anything can make me decide to post something. So not necessarily books or theme first. It just kind of depends on what's taking place, I guess. The next section is reading related questions. So first up, for your videos, you often read many books. How do you not let that slow down your schedule? Now, I put this question in here specifically because this was not something that I talked about, but I think is an important side note. Whenever I'm planning my content, I do try to decide what videos are getting posted based on how many books I'm going to read. And I think that kind of happens naturally, right? So I'm not gonna post 2 I Read 5 videos in a row because that would be repetitive. But also, I don't wanna have to do 2 videos back to back where I'm required to read 5 books in a row. So I feel like I don't get slowed down because not every video has so many books in them. And then on top of that, I feel like I read fairly quickly. I think I touched on it a little bit, but if a book is 350 pages or less, I can read it quite easily in a day. So book a day, I can get an I Read 5 video done and still have a day where I don't read at all. So yeah, I like to give myself a little grace, but I honestly don't feel like I'm ever bogged down by my schedule or like, oh my god, I have so many books to read and I don't have enough time to do it. I don't really tend to feel that, mostly because it's something I've learned over the years. There were years like in the beginning where I would plan too many things back to back that required me to read too many books and I would get really stressed out and I'd be up till midnight like reading or vlogging. That doesn't happen anymore. I've kind of like learned over the years what is too much for me. The next question is, does reading feel like a chore now that you're on YouTube? I would say no. There have been times in the past where it has felt that way. I think like I was trying to say just a second ago, in the past I have maybe scheduled myself too tightly and not given myself enough grace to kind of have chill days or days where I don't read as much. And in those cases, I do feel like reading did kind of feel like a chore. Nowadays, not so much. And I try to be really good about picking stuff that I know I'm going to enjoy, not picking up things that are not going to spark joy. And then also giving myself time in my schedule to read random shit. Shit that just excites me and isn't related to a video in any sense. Obviously, I can make any book fit into a video theme. If I have just one book, I'm like, okay, I can build a theme around this and make a video. But sometimes I think it's just fun to be able to just pick up a book on a whim and read it. And again, I think that helps me feel a little bit less stifled by having a schedule. It's like, well, I can read this random book because I don't have anything on the schedule for today. So no, reading doesn't feel like a chore presently. Next question is, how do you balance reading what you want and what videos require? I think I touched on that just a second ago, but I thought I'd kind of expand a little bit more. It really comes down to sticking to the schedule. And I think the schedule actually allows me to read what I want. It's like a symbiotic relationship, right? So if I want to read the kind of like random on a whim books, I have to make sure that I'm ahead of schedule or I'm on schedule. So for me, it's easy to balance it because I know that they can live in harmony if I stick to what I'm supposed to be doing. The next question is, how do you track things that you read but you don't video? And I'm assuming that's referring to the books I was just talking about, the books I read for pleasure, and the books that end up in my monthly wrap-up. So for those, I use my notes app. I know, shocking. I pull up a new note, I title it September wrap-up, and any book I read in the month of September that I finish that's not for a video, I will write down the title of the book. Sometimes I'll type notes. Usually I do that the day that I film my wrap-up, but I just have kind of a running list on there. And then I also use Goodreads to track all of my reading, so things never really get lost. I don't forget what books that I read. Last question in the reading section is, what do you do when you really don't want to read a book? Now, this is a pretty easy answer, I guess. I don't read the book, but I do try to create a balance because I do like doing videos where I'm just reading things I like, you know, like a Kindle Unlimited reading vlog, but sometimes I want to get outside of my comfort zone and read something that I could potentially not like. So I try to balance those video types. And if it's a book for a video, like, okay, I'm reading Y'all's Favorites in December. There is one book in that video that I know that I'm not excited about. So I will be putting that off until the last possible second. That's gonna happen, procrastination. And I will give myself a long time to read that book. If I don't wanna read the book, I won't read the book. If I need to read the book, but it's not a book I want to read, procrastinate and then give myself a lot of time to read it. That's the answer. Now moving into the editing and uploading section. So I particularly put this section in here because I didn't really talk about any of that whenever I was telling you how I plan my content. I think this will illuminate a lot of things. So the first question is, how do you store all your pre-filmed content? So I think there's this assumption that I pre-film everything and that like all of these videos just live on my computer. That's not really the case. I mean, I obviously do have some content that I'm not going to post for a while on my computer, but not a ton. I don't have just like hours and hours of footage just sitting somewhere. The first thing is that I made sure that I bought a computer where I could add storage to it. So it's really beefy and I could probably upload like days and days worth of footage on there if I really needed to store it, but I directly put all of my pre-filmed content into my Final Cut Pro app, and then once my card is full, I will create a folder on my desktop and put all of the stuff on there. So if for some reason a particular file is corrupted, I still have the original on my desktop, but I don't have a very sophisticated way of doing things. I do like to keep my content directly where it belongs, like keep it in that particular folder on Final Cut where it belongs, but I don't have any like particular interesting system. That's just kind of how I do things. Next question, do you batch record or batch edit? Do you plan out when a video is posted or also when to film, edit, upload, etc.? And how fast do you edit your videos? I put these all together so I can kind of talk about my editing process all at once. So the only thing that I batch record on my channel are my video intros. I try to set aside like the first Saturday of a month and film all of the intros for the videos in advance. I know I said that I like every part of the YouTube process and the planning process. Mostly true, but I really, really hate doing video intros, mostly because it's a pain in the ass to like set up my lights and everything in the way that I like to aesthetically have things set up for my thumbnails, you know, especially. So I try to just knock that out on one Saturday, change outfits, change hairstyles, whatever I have to do to make sure there's a little bit of variety, but like things look nice. So anyway, batch record my intros. That's the only thing that I batch record. I can't really like batch record vlog clips. I edit as I go, which I know is probably not the most efficient thing, but for me, it just feels natural. It feels organic. And I also like that I don't have to sit down at my computer for hours at a time to edit a video, right? So I will sit down and film an update for a vlog, which will usually be between 3 and 10 minutes. I'll take the SD card out of my camera. I'll put it into my computer, upload it to Final Cut, edit it, and then move along with my day. It doesn't take very long for me. I'm a really quick editor at this point. I wouldn't say that I've like memorized waveforms, but I do know my waveforms for ums, likes, and times where there's big pauses, and I can edit those out very, very efficiently. So for me, it doesn't take very long, and that's just kind of how I like to edit things. For the occasional list video or sit down video like this one, okay, I guess those are two separate categories for me, but for a list video, I will usually give myself 2 days to edit, and it's usually the 2 days after I film. And then for a sit down video like this, that's a little shorter, I will literally just put it into my computer after I'm done filming, edit it, and get done with it. Like, I like to be as quick as possible. I don't know if it's the most efficient or best use of time possible, but that's how I get things done. And that's why in my planner, you won't see a lot of edit this video at this point, unless it's like, you know, a sit down video. This is another footage related question, but it is a good one. It's how do you not get the footage mixed up when filming several videos at the same time? So sometimes I will film a couple of clips back to back for different videos. Like I'll be reading 3 books at once. I'll film 3 clips for 3 different books. And sometimes things can get a little confusing. But again, I think part of the benefit of immediately editing things is that immediately I put the clips where they're supposed to go. Also, I'm pretty good at knowing what outfit I was wearing when I filmed a certain clip. So I kind of know where things go based on that. I never go more than a day or two without taking stuff from an SD card onto my computer. Like I don't just have things sitting there for days. Like I don't film an entire week's worth of clips and then try to edit it because that would be chaos. So it's not super hard to keep things separate. And then lastly, we move into miscellaneous questions. So this will hopefully answer any other things that you might want to know. First up, what are your favorite videos to film how often do you make these? Almost everything I'd like to film, or almost everything that gets filmed, are my favorite. Like, I like the things that I post, and there's not really anything I post at this point that I'm, like, dreading. Sometimes I dread my wrap-ups if they're super long, because I know I'm gonna have to edit in 20 book covers back-to-back, but I still like filming those. So, really my favorite videos to film would be my list videos. I just love how easy they are to get done. Like, it seems like such a big feat, right, to read that many books back-to-back. I love getting to check each book off the list as I read them. I like that I get to kind of read them in my downtime between other videos, and I like that I don't have to film vlog clips for them. Like, there's something really freeing about just being able to read a book in its entirety without having to update. So I really like list videos, but pretty much everything I make, I really enjoy. Next up, do you ever plan to post more if you feel the need to make more money in a month? Now, I included this question because I feel like that's a very valid question and something that I think doesn't get talked about enough. So there are two different ways to make money on YouTube. I think everybody kind of knows by now, but there is AdSense revenue that you can make, you know, ads before, in the middle, or at the end of videos, and then making money from sponsorships. This is something that people maybe do, like posting more in a month to make more money, if they do sponsored content. Because if you do, let's say, like an advertisement for someone inside of your video, right, they will give you a lump sum fee for that video, so like $300. You know for a fact you're gonna make $300 from that sponsorship. So the more that you do, ostensibly the more that you can make. When it comes to AdSense money, you could have two videos with the same amount of views make completely different amounts of money. So it doesn't really behoove you to post more to make more money, unless it's gonna be something like posting 5 videos a month versus 10 videos a month, in which case you would, you know, probably make more money when you post 10 videos. All of that to say, that is not something that really plays into my decision making when it comes to how many videos I'm gonna upload in a given month, because I don't do sponsored content. One video wouldn't make a meaningful difference, and even if it did, like, that's just not really like my motivator here. Do you choose videos you're interested in, or ones you think we will be interested in? I think I touched on this earlier, I don't know if I did 100%, but I really like to post videos that I'm excited about, and I hope as a result y'all will be excited about. I feel like it's very obvious when someone is enjoying the thing that they're making. I think it's been obvious in the past when I've made something that I wasn't excited about, but I thought other people would be excited about, so I try to just stick with what I like and what I'm into. Next question is how I make thumbnails. I use PowerPoint. Surprisingly, PowerPoint is actually like the right dimensions for a YouTube thumbnail if you save it correctly, but naturally the ratio works well with PowerPoint, and it was a tool that I already knew how to use. I could download different fonts, I can do a bunch of different things in it. I really like PowerPoint. I know a lot of people use like Canva or like other tools. I just use PowerPoint, it works really well for me. I thought about doing a tutorial, but like I don't think it's worth doing because it's basic. It's exactly what it sounds like. I put the picture that I take from my camera into PowerPoint, I blow it up to the sides of the slide, put some text on it, and that's it. It's not super fancy. Yeah, I just use PowerPoint. How many videos are you working on at one time? So I'll answer for right now. For right now, I'm working on 5 or 6 videos, mostly because of how far I have planned in advance right now. they're just some books that have seemed interesting or I've gotten off of hold for my library too soon, and so I'm trying to get those read. So that's how many videos I'm working on at one time, like currently, presently, usually probably about 2. Next question is, do you write scripts or notes for your videos? I feel like it's pretty obvious which videos are scripted and which aren't, but I could be completely wrong. The videos that are scripted and like notes have been taken are the list videos that I do. I try to make them funny and like write the like jokes and shit in advance, and the sexual puns and whatnot, sexual innuendo. I try to make notes for those videos. Also, if I'm doing a recommendations video, I do try to write notes. Mostly for those videos, I try to just put down who our main characters are, kind of the gist of the book and why I'm recommending it. But I do try to not read directly from the script, just have the notes there. And then for vlog clips, absolutely not scripted, which I feel like is very obvious. This video, for instance, not really that scripted. I did have, you know, kind of like a list of things that I wanted to make sure I covered, but I didn't read directly from it. I would say most stuff isn't scripted though, because most of what I post is vlogs. Next question, what's the furthest out you've ever planned and filmed a video? So for this one, I was trying to think back at all of the videos that I've posted over the past few years. I think the first list video I ever did, where I read 27 books, I think, from a BuzzFeed list. That one I planned, I think, I want to say it was in the fall of 1 year. I can't remember if it was 2019, fall of 2019, something like that. I planned the video because I remember I filmed the video intro for that in October, and I didn't post the video until February of the next year. So I feel like the video had to have been planned before October. So how many months is that? I don't know. I think it was probably 6 months in advance. Let's go with 6 months. And then the last question that I'll leave you with is, how far in advance do you currently have planned? Currently, I have planned until the first week of January. I am planning on posting every day in December, and to do that, to accomplish that, there's a lot of stuff that I need to get pre-filmed ahead of time. So right now I am working on like a couple of videos for September and a couple of videos for December because I need to make sure that I'm getting everything done. And in terms of my planning process and like how that's affected it, it honestly has not changed that much. It just means that I'm having to be a little bit more creative with how I schedule things and how I put things on hold for my library. It's like anytime something gets off of hold, I'm like immediately trying to fill that void with something else to put on hold because there's just so much I have to read and get done, but I'm excited about it. And I'm just trying to experiment and see how this works because I have never planned, I would say, more than 2 months in advance before, like an entire month's worth of content in advance, more than 2 months. So however many months that is planned in advance, it was September, October, November, December, and the first week of January. So 4 months in a week, I guess. That's how far I have planned. I'm excited about it. I'm excited to bring this content to you, and I'm hoping that I'm able to accomplish it. I like to set kind of lofty goals for myself. I think that's maybe evident by my random list videos. I just like pushing the limits and seeing how much I can do, and I'm excited to bring that stuff to you. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope this answered any questions you might have about my particular planning process. If I left anything out, if there's anything you're desperate to know, leave me a comment down below and let me know kind of what sorts of, additional questions you have. I would also love to know in the comments any tools or anything that you use to plan your own content if you make videos. I'm always curious to see how people do things, and if maybe I'm doing something really inefficiently, maybe you can give me, you know, a pointer and point something out that I should be doing differently. So thanks so much for watching. I love y'all so much. And until next Sunday.